Grandma's Kitchen.
There's a fiddle tune and a wooden spoon while she's stirring and singing. There's friends leaving our family land, and then the phone's usually ringing. No matter who you are or what you've done, everything's forgiven. And ain't it good to be in Grandma's Kitchen?
From Tunes and Wooden Spoons, and that was the lovely Lynn Chisholm from right here in Port Hood and newly elected municipal councillor for our area, and we're very proud of her. And by day she's a counselor, and she's an educational assistant at the school, and she is a musician that gives so much to her community, and I'm so happy to have her here. And she's a former Mobile girl.
Right on.
Same as me.
There you go. We're together in this.
That's right. So I'm going to steal the microphone and see if I can get this on correctly. And I'm going to bring you around to the kitchen. There now. Hello there. And I'll straighten you out so you're not looking at my crooked ceiling there. Anyway, I wanted to say hi to everybody. It's been a wonderful week. We've had a little snow. I've been in touch with so many of you, and it's a great thing. I want to say a special hello out there to someone, Austin Holly. Hi, Austin. We've been back and forth this week, and he was a graduate in the 60s from Mabu Consolidated School, and he and his brother lived, they were formerly from Antigonish, or formerly from Inganish, I should say. And anyway, been back and forth with him, so it's so nice to touch base with people who really have a soft spot for Mabu and the education that they received there. And of course, we have all kinds of connections when it comes right down to it, so it's a wonderful thing. And so anyway, we're going to be making our chocolate truffles. And so for those who are making it with me, and having a mold is great. But if you don't have a mold, we have something that you can do with the cans, and that'll be fine. And somebody said they have their tea and their pork pies ready. I forget who that was there, but that is a wonderful thing. Now, this is the mold that I'm going to be using today, this one, and I think I'll make this one. I'll probably just make two trays with you so you know what we're doing, and then we'll hear some more from the lovely Lynn. And I gave you all the recipe for the filling, and for those who are actually making it along with me today, you'll have already made it and refrigerated it. But for today's purposes, I'm actually going to make it again, and I'll put it in the refrigerator, but I'll use the filling that I had made a couple of days ago. So anyway, it's so important when we are working with this chocolate. I know you are all wonderful and clean and all of that, but I am definitely going to wash my hands again from handling the phone and the mic, because you're going to be using your thumbs, and we want to make sure that it's just absolutely perfect. Okay, so just wash your hands, and we don't have to set an oven today, okay? After last week's chocolate balls, I swear I had chocolate everywhere. I had it on my nose, I had it on my arms, I had it on my blazer that I was wearing. But it was great, and they're so delicious, and so many people wrote that they had actually made it. And last night, I got a call from my daughter Kelly, and she was with a group of her close friends in Herring Cove, and they were making the coconut balls and the Oreo cookie balls, and just they get together like once a month, and it's a beautiful thing. So anyway, we're going to start right away. I'm going to try something different today, and it may work. I'm hoping it will work, and I'll tell you a little story first about it. Of course, me and my stories. I had, when I was working out in the oil sands, I worked there for a few years, and when a construction company packs up and gets everything ready to go, you know, I was usually one of the last ones to be packing it up with the project manager and all of that, and somebody left behind this induction heater, and I didn't know how it worked or whatever, but I said, being from a Scotch background, I didn't want to throw it in the garbage, and so I hauled it home in my suitcase, and it's been here for years, and I have never used it once. And I would turn it on, and I didn't know how it worked, and nothing would happen. Turns out, this is how it works. You have to have a pot that has a bottom on it that a magnet will stick to, because there's a certain amount of, I don't know the science, carbon or something. And it interacts with the surface of the heater, and actually boils water really, really quickly. So I have it right here on my table instead of hauling you over with the camera and adjusting the camera and turning you down to my stove. So I'm going to try to use it today. So I'm fingers crossed that this will work. So that's what we're going to start with today. I'm going to pull you over here so that you can see what I'm doing. All right. I'm going to turn you down so you can see that pot. I think I just broke my little thing there. We'll manage though. Okay, can you see this? Okay. So this is my induction pan and my pot. And I'm going to turn it on. And the very first thing that I am going to put in there is 3/4 cup of butter. My microphone just kind of fell on the floor, people, so I'm just going to fix that. There we go. So I'm going to put that 3/4 cup of butter. Some people ask about, you know, can you use margarine or whatever. You know what? You use what you want to use. I'm using the butter, and I'm going to put this on a low temperature and melt this butter. Okay. And it's working. Isn't that a great thing? I'm actually going to cut it up a little bit so that it'll go a little faster. This butter is already soft. Not that that matters, I don't think, but this is such an easy recipe. And I got this recipe from a gal that I worked with at the school board office many, many years ago. I always call her Nicole Coyne, but she's actually Nicole McKenzie. She lives in Antigonish now. And Nicole, if you are watching, she gave me lots of great recipes and great muffin recipes. And she loved to cook. And I bet you she has all her meat pies ready for Christmas. She would make them, I swear, 20 at a time. And just an amazing cook. But Nicole, if you're listening, if you're out there, I am definitely going to be calling you this week to touch base. So here we go. This is melting up really, really nicely. Now, into this, you're going to add 3/4 cup of cocoa. And it's great if you have a sieve of any size or a sifter, whatever you want. I just have a little one. I think I got them at the dollar store. There's a set of 3. And because sometimes if you don't sift your cocoa, you'll have lumps. I'm going to control this heat. Okay. I'm actually going to turn that off so that it's not too hot. And I'm just going to shake that in. Because cocoa sometimes will just tend to have lumps in it. I want to say another big hello out there to Andrea Beaton, the fiddle player that was here a couple of weeks ago. And her and Vigo, her little boy, I think he's 4, are making these today with us down in Mabu. And somebody else I want to say a big hello to there is Anne McComb out there in BC. Anne is the one who made me, I showed you a little while ago, a few weeks ago, a painting she did of Santa Claus, which is hanging in my entryway here. But she also made me one of, God, this is taking so long, it shouldn't take this long. She also gave me one of Winnie the Pooh and all of the characters that are in Winnie the Pooh cartoon, and she painted that for me. Oh my God, it is so beautiful. And so anyway, Andrea was here, just popped in to for a quick visit to drop something off. I think I bought some coffee from her. She has a little coffee shop in Mabu. And so anyway, she saw this and she loved it, and I gifted it to her. I just thought, this re-gifting thing. I thought it was just a beautiful thing. And I told Anne McComb about it, and she was absolutely fine with that. So thank you, Anne, for your beautiful painting abilities. And she shares lots of recipes with me. Okay, finally, that's going in there. So I'm going to use my little whisk here. This is one from Pampered Chef. I'm going to stir that up a little bit. So it's all melted in there and well mixed. And because you sifted it, there'll be no lumps. Just stir it until there are no lumps left. Turn that on again. And into that, I better find the recipe here before I'm telling you the wrong thing. A can of sweetened condensed milk. It's a 300 ml can of sweetened condensed milk. Someone on the Facebook page was wondering what size can it was, but I think it only comes in this size can of sweetened condensed milk, or, you know, the brand name Eagle brand milk. We always call it that. It's definitely not carnation milk, which is evaporated milk. This is sweetened condensed milk. I mean, see that there was some question about that, but it is definitely the sweetened condensed milk. Perfect. Now I'm just going to mix that up. I'm going to stir it probably for a couple of minutes is all. So back in the 90s, I think I made about 400 of these little chocolates, heart-shaped chocolates, for my daughter's wedding. And a tiny little, I made my own jam and put my daughter's name and her husband's name on it and wrote on it preserved and the year. I think it was 1998. And they have four beautiful children together, and that's, they're both parenting those children, and it's a wonderful thing. So, just stir that for a couple of minutes, and you'll see it getting starting to get more shiny, and that's kind of your idea. But if you see, sometimes the butter will start to separate from the mixture, and you'll feel that. And when it gets that stage, take it off right away. All right. It doesn't have to bubble or anything like that. It's just heating up very nicely there. Smells so chocolatey. Oh my God, it smells good. Yeah. I think that's about it. Really only need it for about a couple of minutes there. I'd say that is done. So we're going to remove it from heat. And we're going to add a tablespoon of vanilla. The good stuff. The real stuff is the best. And this, of course, as I've always told you, it's my favorite gal in Mabu, Josephine Carlton McCachran. She sells Watkins. And anytime I need any of those supplies that Watkins sells, I love that product. I just send her a little text, and the next day, if she has it in stock, she delivers it. She's just great. Okay, so that's all there is to the filling. And see if I can move things out of the way here. I am going to just looking for my spoon, but I can't find it, but I'll use this little spoon here. I'm going to put that into a nice glass bowl. And what you're going to do once that, you put that in the fridge uncovered. Uncovered and for at least 4 hours or overnight. It doesn't matter how soon, you can just stay in the fridge, it's just fine. But this is the middle of your truffle. So chocolatey. And you're gonna leave it uncovered in your fridge until it is fairly cold, and then you put your saran wrap on it, because you really don't want it to sweat if you put the plastic wrap over it too soon. So I'm gonna put that in my fridge, and now we're going to make some chocolates. Our son, Gordy, is out of isolation. And where he was renting, of course, he had all these groceries. So he took them up to me. And my fridge is so packed. We've got double of everything. But I'm so glad to have him and to hug him finally after his 2 weeks of isolation, and he's going to be here and with us for Christmas. So it's a beautiful thing. So I have with me my bowl of, this has been chilling for a couple of days. And you can see I took some out of it because I had to make some for demonstration to show you what the final product looked like. So now I'm ready to do that over again. Into our molds, or for those who don't have molds, I'm going to do that first. So the first thing I have to do is chop up my pecans or pecans, whatever you call them, and I'll have that at the ready. So I'm just going to do that. Do you remember this little thing that I was telling everybody? I know a lot of you have actually bought one of these from Amazon, but it's a game changer for me for mozzarella cheese. Just turn the handle and it's grated. It's wonderful, but it also works great with the nuts. So I'm just gonna take my whole pecans and chop up a few. So they're nice, finely grated. Can you see that? All right. And I'm going to turn the camera down again, and I'll show you how to make ones without having the mold, and they're just as delicious. Okay, just a second. Take you down here. So I'm going to get another spoon, a nice clean spoon. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to work with, for the balls, probably about, say, a 1 inch. And just take them in your hand and just roll it up. And then we're just going to roll them. And there is your finished product. And you refrigerate that. I will put mine in I have those little tiny muffin cups, little shells, and put one in there. And I'll do a few of them to put on my tray, and then we'll use the mold. Now you can, you know, if you're not a nut person, you don't want to use nuts, you can roll it in coconut. You can roll it in just icing sugar. They're so, so awesome. Lynn, would you like to try one?
Sure, they look beautiful.
And I'll give you a chocolate before you, afterwards.
You.
All right. And, I'm going to make three or four of these. And they're so easy. I mean, it's fun for kids, you know, too, can do this if they don't want to do the moles.
Oh, my goodness.
Isn't that tasty?
Oh, so good.
Just so decadent.
Mm.
I love them. We'll send you home with some, Lynn.
Oh, this is so,
so
nice.
So you can give Cyril some.
Oh, he's going to be so pleased. He's a chocolate person.
Is he?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's very nice.
Anyway, that just gives you an idea of what you can do as an alternative to using the mold. I'll just do that a little bit. I'll put that on my tray. All right, that's it for that. So now I'm going to get the molds out. So I'm going to do that. I have two molds here. I really wish I had the really nice molds that are very hard plastic and like a hard ice cream tray. These are pretty pliable, and it's a little bit more difficult when you're using these to actually tap them out when they've been tempered in the fridge. So, but we're going to give it our best shot. So what I need to do is melt the chocolate. And we'll do that right now and do this little trusty thing again.
New molds on your Santa list.
Oh, I know, but they're hard to come by, you know? They're really hard to come by. So I'm going to, I have about, an inch and a half in my the bottom of my double boiler. That's how I'm going to melt my chocolate. You can melt the chocolate in the microwave if you want. Make sure you use half power, I used mine on 5, like I was showing you last week. I really, truly love using the double boiler and then keeping it hot in there. So, let me see. I'll bring this to a boil, my water to a boil. And I'm going to, in the top pot, I'm going to put 2 cups of chocolate chips. And instead of using wax, if you still have the Parawax left over from last week, go ahead and use that as per what we did last week. But this week, I'm going to put in 1 tablespoon of shortening instead. It just helps with the shine when you're done. And some people say you use a teaspoon of just oil. Or you can use coconut oil. Or you don't have to use anything at all. You can just melt your chocolate chips. So you be the decision makers on that. And we're going to bring this to a nice melt. This thing is fast, isn't it? Can you see that? The sound is low. Interesting. Okay. I'm not sure. I don't know. It's no different than any other time I've used it. So maybe it's just, you can't hear. I'll just check the connections. And my volume is up. My volume is up at the highest level. So I don't know. I just kind of pushed in the connection at all points, and hope that's okay. I'm okay now. So, and you can hear me fine. Thank you. That's all. That's awesome. It must have been just a little disconnect there. Sorry about that. So anyway, just so you know, while this is heating up the water in my the gingerbread house. You should have seen the gingerbread houses that we made here. I had Ivor and Aiden over, and we made gingerbread houses. I think everybody ate more candy than there was on the house. It was great. Hi, Marilyn Sangster. How are you? Okay, my water is boiling, so I'm going to turn the camera down. Karen Denslow from Summerland, BC. Hi there. Okay. Beautiful to see you all. It says that there's 553 people watching. You guys are the best. Okay. So, I'm going to turn the camera down. And I'm going to put what's going to happen is I am once we start painting the mold, this is the brush that I'm going to be using. It's fairly small. Use whatever you can. I mean, some people just swish the chocolate around to fill the mold. I don't do it that way because this is the way Nicole showed me how to do it. So I'm old-fashioned. I stick with what I know. And if you have a faster way of doing it, that is a wonderful thing. So what I'm going to do is, as soon as this is finished melting, and just till there's no lumps left, I'll turn the heat off entirely, and the water underneath it will keep it nice and smooth and ready for us as we need it. Shortening there. Okay, I'd say that's absolutely perfect. Turn the heat off. Down to do this. Bear with me for a minute. So here's my mold. Will I put out a cookbook? You know, I'm actually working on that. My daughter Margie has agreed to help me with that, and we're looking at a springtime cookbook, but it won't just be a cookbook. Of course, I have too much to say, so it'll be a little more than that. We're going to have a few stories in there, of course, and just something a little bit extra. And I remember telling you that, or showing you really, that the cookbook that I have of my mother's. That would have been, she would have written in the late 40s, early 50s, because she died in 55, and I mean, she was sick for about 3 years there, so it had to be in the early 50s, but I'm hoping to, I've already begun typing it all of her hints and pieces of wisdom and her simple recipes. So that's going to be a part of it too. So it's going to be a different book. It's going to be a book, not just a recipe book. So I hope you'll enjoy that. Okay, so we're going to start, and this is what I do. I just take my paintbrush, and I just take a bunch. I don't know if you can see this. I'm going to put this up closer so you can see it. And you just put it in, and you bring the chocolate up to the edge. So this will be the shell off your chocolate. You're going to bring it up right to the edge. And if you have any, like, transparent parts, don't worry about it, because you're going to repeat this one more time. So what I was going to tell you is, when I put this in the fridge, when I'm done, how many do I have on here? 15? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15. I'm going to put it in the fridge for 5 minutes to harden up, and our lovely Lynn will play a tune for you while that's in the fridge. And then we'll come and we'll do the second coat, and that'll be in there for another 5 minutes. So we'll have another song. And then we will fill it with the truffle mixture. And then we will put the top coat on. And that goes in the fridge for 20 minutes. And then we'll have our lovely Lynn play some Christmas music and mix it up a bit with her beautiful singing, and we will then enjoy a cup of tea, and it'll be great. So are you all okay with that? Hi, Teresa Bond. Darlene McDonald Johnson. Darn it, I missed the message. I can only see two at a time when they come up. So dip as you feel necessary. You don't have to be generous. You can be generous, I'm meant to say, if you wanted to. Try to only get it up to the top and not too much on the sides, because if it goes off on the sides over the top, that will be something you'll have to cut off at the end. This is just like painting class, really. Can you imagine doing almost 400 of these for your daughter? The things mothers do for their daughters. But it really doesn't take, you know, it really doesn't take that long. When I was doing it, I have, I think, 4 or 5 of these heart molds. So I just had a complete, you know, assembly line going. It'd be in the fridge, I'd be taking another one out, I'd be filling it, putting it back in the fridge, and that it was great. And then I bought all the little gold foil to wrap them in, and they were so cute. And they truly are delicious. I'm a little bit messy there. I'll clean that up in a minute before too long. Yeah. You don't want that. I'll have chocolate all over me by this time this is done as well. So if there's any transparent spots that you're seeing in your own or in mine, don't worry. We have a second round coming up, and it will thicken up that layer. There we go. And if you feel that your chocolate is getting thick, just, you know, turn your burner on a little bit. Just make sure to keep it nice and liquidy. Okay. I know there's probably questions there. I'll try to check on those. I'll get back to you. Might take me a couple of days sometimes before I get back to people. Okay, just have a little look. I see some spots that I missed there, for example. Just have a look at that. Little repair jobs, just like that. Okay, I'm actually going to time this for 5 minutes in my fridge. All right. And I'll be turning it over to Lynn. I'm just gonna set the timer and we'll get this just perfectly done. I live by my timer, Lynn.
I don't blame you.
It's perfect. Because I forget.
Yes, there can be lots going on.
That's right. There you are. Now I have another mold, and while she's singing, I'm gonna fill the other one and have them in, so I have a couple to show you. And I'm gonna turn this around so you can see Miss Lynn.
Miss Lynn, yes. Well, Mary Janet, this is so nice.
I'm so glad you're here, Lynn. There. Now I'll be bringing it closer to her. For a double boiler, just use a bowl over the water. Works fine. Yes, anybody who wasn't watching last week, that's an option. And you can use a glass bowl that's, you know, heat proof and put it over the boiling water and melt it that way. Or melt it in the microwave and bring it down in the bowl and let it sit over the a pot of boiling water. Just be very safety conscious that you're not doing the wrong thing there. And I'm going to turn this over to Lynn. Now, a little later when she's going to sing for a while, I will bring you closer to Lynn so you can see her beautiful face a little bit better.
Thank you, Mary Janet. This is so nice. And I know now why they call this Tunes and Wooden Spoons.
Yes.
This house is so beautiful, folks, and so cozy. It's so unbelievable. And I want to take this time to thank Mary Janet for inviting me here.
You're
this is
welcome.
So nice. And especially the taste of those is that truffle? What do you call
truffles?
Truffles.
They are truffles.
Absolutely beautiful, folks. And as I was watching her do her cooking, as I said, in her cozy house, the next song I thought about doing was actually Country Roads. So I will do that, and then I will come back with a few Christmas songs after, and sing along with me out there.
And the 5 minutes is up. And
let me get that out of the fridge. I better take my microphone back. You won't be able to hear me. Okay. There, people. Oh, that's one of my favorite songs. Thank you, Lynn.
Oh,
it's awesome.
It's a beautiful song. Just like your family's album is called Country Roads, isn't it?
It's called Company Road.
Yes,
Company
yes,
Road.
Right. Yeah.
And the reason they called it Company Road is because that's where Cecil grew up.
Right, yes.
And they had lots of good memories.
Oh, another nice piece of history.
Okay. So they've been in there for 5 minutes. And I am going to go ahead and paint a second layer. They probably could have stayed in a little bit longer, but that's all right. We'll still put our second coat in there. This is just, if you make these, and they make so many, it's just such a nice, they work up so nice in the end to give to, you know, somebody that is in the service industry, you know, like your postal worker, your mail delivery person, teacher, educational assistant, or, you know, it's just, everybody loves a little treat. Today, actually, in Port Hood, I was in church this morning, and after church, they had what the heck is that called? Shepherd's pie dinner at the hall. The ladies of the hall of you know, the church were putting that on, and so somebody I'm not allowed to mention sent me $90 as a donation and towards the shepherd's pie. And if I would give six dinners out to six people who would love to have it on today. So, and then somebody else heard about it, somebody close to me, and they put another $90 in, so I was able to bring 12 beautiful dinners to some of the seniors in Port Hood. I had one guy in the seniors department said, I'll give them out, and he did. And it's just, oh, isn't it? That's just such a nice idea. Sometimes I just wouldn't think of that. I always think of food and stuff like that, but you know what? Sometimes it's hard for them to get out or whatever. It's you know, and I thought that was so special. And thanks to those donors for doing that. It was a nice little treat for sure. So this time, you know what? I think I will. I'm going to put this next stage, I'm going to put it actually in the freezer for the 5 minutes. I think because I have so much stuff in my fridge that it's still, the first layer is not exactly hard, but it's fine because it's making a nice thick coating and it'll all be beautiful. And my kettle is boiling because we'll be soon having tea with the beautiful Lynn.
They're all missing this lovely day here.
Yes, it's so nice. Lynn, how many albums do you have out? Is it two?
I have three.
You have three. There now. Are they available on iTunes? I was going to say YouTube, but iTunes?
The Follow Your Heart album is on. Online, but the other two no. The first one was Tommy, and I made so many copies. People just love that because it was the old country.
Yeah, the old country. Yeah. Love it. Okay, back in the fridge. With this, I'm actually going to put it in the freezer. Something. Oh, do you have to? You don't have to put them in the freezer. You can put them in the fridge, but just whatever. Do you need a special food-safe paintbrush? You know what? I don't know, but I just bought a bunch of paint artist brushes. That's what I used. The hair doesn't come out of them. They're just dollar store, and they work absolutely fine. So don't worry about food safe. They're fine. I've been doing it for many years, and nobody got sick yet anyway, so I hope that they're okay. And yeah, I'm just going to put these in my freezer, and I'm going to time it for 5 minutes. I'll see what they're like at 5 minutes. And I want to make sure that they'll have a dull finish to it and you know that they're set. But just to kind of rush it, I'm going to put it in the freezer. And you see how they are. They'll get that dull finish on the inside when you know that they've hardened. All right. Is there any other questions at this moment before I put this in the freezer? In case there is. My kettle is boiling and I'm ready to make my tea in a minute. So, hi Jenny MacDonald. I think that's Jenny from Sudbury, formerly from Mabu. Hi Jenny.
One of Malcolm Finley ours. Oh, yes, they're actually Charlie Pride request. We talked about that before the show, and Lynn will be doing a Charlie Pride song in memory of dear Charlie Pride, whom we love. And is the recipe online? The recipe is online. It should be on my Facebook page, but it's also on my website at www.toonsandwoodenspoons.com. And that's it. So I'm going to put these in the freezer. I'm going to say for 5 minutes. And while that's on, Lynn is going to sing us another song.
No, it was another gentleman that was requesting it.
All right, we shall do.
So, I'll bring this over to you, Lynn.
All right, a little Charlie Pride request, and yes, we're all very saddened to hear another beautiful singer has left us.
Did you hear, Lynn, was it from COVID?
It was COVID, yes.
Damn.
I heard it last night at a little gig I was playing in Inverness at the Fire Hall for Chasey Ace, and I heard it and I thought, what happened? And this morning's news told me that it was COVID related. So that's just too bad. But you know what? Kiss an angel good morning. Let's all sing along to this in our memory of Charlie Pride.
That have died because of COVID.
Well, John Prine.
John Prine.
Kenny Rogers. Did Kenny?
I don't know. No. I can't think of all of them right now, but I know Cecil would remember.
Yeah.
But
very sad.
And that's just the way the world is today.
Absolutely.
That's right.
As John Prine would say. It's the way the world goes
round. That's the way the world goes round.
Absolutely.
Oh, that's for sure. So, Joe Diffie. Yes, that's
Joe Diffie.
Joe Diffie. Absolutely. Somebody just said that.
Thank you, Lynn. Yes,
right close to John Prine, too, in timing.
Yeah, that's right, too. The silicone molds, I've never used the silicone molds, but I'm sure they're just fine. And John Prine, yeah, we mentioned John Prine that had died. But the silicone molds, I'm sure they're fine. And, you know, sometimes you can get those small ice trays at the dollar store, and they have kind of like a bit of silicone at the bottom, so they're easier to pop out. They're meant for ice, but I'm sure they would work really great, right? Anne McComb is saying, beautiful singing. She's all the way from BC. Yes. I'll show you the Santa picture in the porch. You see that.
Yes.
But, hi, Lori. Lori, Pat Malcolm's daughter.
Oh, our darling Lori.
Lori, can you see Lynn there?
Hi, Lori. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Lori. I know this is killing you. Absolutely. You're down. She's down in Massachusetts, and it's tough. It really is tough.
Yes.
But Lori, you know you always hold a special place in my heart. All of you girls.
Absolutely.
And Lori's sister, Donna, actually was named after my father. So she's Donna, but my father was Donald.
And nice.
Yeah, she, Pat and Marie were expecting Donna when my father died and when they had the baby, whether it was going to be a girl or a boy, they were calling after my father.
So special.
Oh, Rochelle, thank you for mailing me a card. You know what? So many people have sent me cards this week, and oh my gosh, I can't remember her. This one person from Antigonish, I can't remember your name right now, but I have it. For next week, I am going to be wearing what you sent me. I will tell everybody. Oh, who was that? Somebody said, did you get my parcel yet? So anyway, this person from Antigonish, this lovely follower, sent me cinnamon roll earrings.
Oh my goodness.
And so next Sunday, I'll tell you all about what's happening next Sunday, but I will be wearing those earrings next Sunday. I'm sorry, the name just won't come to me, and my sister Bernice is going to kill me, but I was saving it for next week, but now that somebody mentioned it, it will be a nice little visit next weekend over at Mitchell's house, because we haven't done a show from there. Donna Robertson. Yes, thanks, Bernice. Donna Robertson, I got the earrings. Cecil and I opened it, and I said, oh, my God. She was shopping for something and saw these earrings and reminded her of me, and she's a faithful watcher, I guess. And so I'm going to be wearing them. I'll be wearing my little circle cinnamon roll earrings. I can't wait. I just love them. But and people who have sent me things and cards, I appreciate every one of them. You don't feel like you have to do that. I'm just saying thank you. It was so nice of you to remember that. Okay, the buzzer is ringing. I'm going to check to see how these are doing in the freezer, and I'll decide whether we're going to fill them. My address, look. Port Hood is such a small town. Everybody knows everybody, but I'll tell you, my postal code is B0E2W0, and my address is 288 East Street. Oh my God, I'm asking for trouble. Tell Santa that I was good.
Right.
Hold on, I'm going to check on this. Oh, yeah. These are ready.
Oh, they look beautiful.
Okay, so there is your shell off the hearts, and they're all, can you see up close that they're at the dull finish? And you know that now they're ready for the filling. Oh, I will definitely post a picture. Where you're going to see it very soon, because I'm going to be popping them out here. Pray. Sometimes they're hard to get out of the molds if you don't have a hard mold. So now we're going to fill these and then top it off with the melted chocolate on the top. So I'm going to turn you around, and this is the last stage. This is where the magic happens. Okay. So I didn't finish the other mold that I had going here, but at least if I do one mold full, you'll know what I mean and how we're doing this. Okay, so now I'm gonna take my filling. And the thing to remember when you're doing this is you don't want to fill it up level to the top, because you need to leave room there for the melted chocolate to fill in the top. So I'm gonna start maybe with a half a teaspoon, this kind of a teaspoon, and I'm gonna just see how that will work. I think that's already too much. I'm gonna take half of that off. And basically you're gonna, I use my fingers, nice clean hands, and spread that out. And you can tell that there's a space there in the top. Okay. You don't want it even. Okay. That's great. Now, I said a half a teaspoon, but that's for this particular mold, because these are not thick and fat. The other mold that I started there, you're gonna have a lot more filling requirement to go in there, but don't take it right to the top. Depending on what you're using, don't take it all the way to the top. Okay. You gotta really love the person you're giving this to. Tell you who it is. It's Mick Tomlinson. Mick, that means you're not watching me if you're calling me. Now Mick Tomlinson, he's a great fella. His daughter Kelly is married to our son Brennan. So Mick is a character, and I just love him. He is great. And we worked together actually out west for a time. And he lives in a little place called Minasville. Out, you take, well, when I go to their place, which isn't often, near, I take the exit from Truro, and they live in an absolutely beautiful seaside spot down there, where they, along the tidal bore, which is an amazing thing. If you were ever had the opportunity to go there, you would see these amazing tides rush in.
So Brennan, if you're watching today, call Mick and tell him why I didn't take his call. There's probably something that I should be doing just to prevent calls from coming in. I unplug my house phone every Sunday now, as that has happened in the past, so that I don't get any calls. But I really don't know what to press to not have phone calls coming in. And don't you know, my kids will be after me now and say, Mom, all you have to do is push this button, whatever, and it'll be just fine. And then I'll learn one more technical thing. In 2020, I've had to learn a lot. Not that I know everything great, but I've learned a lot that I didn't think I'd ever know. Okay, we've got one more here, people. And turn that off. Okay, they're all filled. I don't know if you can see that. Just mute the sound on your phone. So how do I mute the sound? Is that one of those buttons on the side? But that won't interfere with the sound off the show. That's what I don't know. Okay, so this is what I am going to do. I'm going to pour a little on every one, and I'll rub off the excess. Huh? Oh, it is, isn't it? It's just fun for painting. It just really is. It's just a beautiful thing. So I'm just going to fill that in with my brush. All the corners. Oh, I put way too much on that one, but that's all right. We can fix all of that very shortly. And as soon as I scrape the excess off of this so that it's level, I'm going to put it in the freezer. I think I'm going to put these in the freezer just because my fridge is so full. Normally I just leave them in the fridge for 20 minutes, but my fridge is really, really full at the moment. And so that they're nice and hard, and you know, after the 20 minutes is up, I'll take them out and we will try to pop them out of here, and I'll put them in their little foil molds or whatever. We have a couple of options and you can see the finished product. I was a little too generous putting these dollops on some of these, way too much. We'll get that. There. The little induction burner stopped the fan. You can probably hear me better. Okay. So, I'm gonna use this or something nice with a sharp edge. Say a prayer. This is gonna work. Turn that around. So I'm just gonna kind of just even it off like that. Don't worry about the chocolate being spread out, but that. Well, that's not going well. I guess I've got to scrape this off. Now, that should be fine. I'll just do a little bit more there. Okay. They're nice and filled. And I'm gonna put them in the freezer for 20 minutes. Doesn't matter if they're in the freezer or the fridge, but I'm just hoping that they'll be, popping them in the freezer so that I know for sure they'll be done in 20 minutes. Okay. And you'll have to have a bumpy ride back to the living room. Just hold on. Okay. Not too bad. Just a few little technical things I have to look after here. The flipper worked great. Yeah, it did. Do you know what? It would be good. I'll put a little Christmas wish in there from Tammy. Tammy, if Pampered Chef, she sends me all these sweet things from Pampered Chef. But you know one of those things, I don't know what they're called. They're like a little rectangle thing with the handle on the top, and you can cut your dough with it. I know so many people are in the same boat. Holly McIntosh is saying the first Christmas without anyone home, any of their children, and it's so sad, so many. But you know what, it's just this Christmas,
right?
We're going to be back on track next year, and we'll have
bigger and better.
Exactly. Now, Lynn, I'm going to take this over closer to you.
Sure.
Just bear with me.
Just a jack of all trades here.
Well, I don't know. But you want to see the lovely Lynn?
Wow, folks, this lady, I'm telling you, she's just a jack of all trades. Look at her. I just love it here.
So lucky to have so many beautiful people who come and entertain out of the goodness of their heart. Mm. Lynn being another. And she's busy, like myself, every weekend between grandchildren and council now and learning and
whatever comes at me, I just go with
it. Go with it.
Yes, exactly.
All right, then you take it away for the next little while. I'll be back maybe to talk to you in between.
Sure. Yes.
Just to exactly. Have a little check. How's that looking for you?
That's likewise? Good. Maybe you want to put it over. Do you want to put it over more that way, Mary Jane? Just toward the front, because it'll be easier. Perfect. Because now I can look at my
your words there.
Yes, exactly. And
is it straight?
Now it is. Yeah. There we go. Hi, everybody. How are you doing out there? It's so much fun. Technology is so beautiful to be able to connect with everybody. And first off, I just want to wish you all a Merry Christmas and a healthy and happy new year. It's going to be a great 2021. I keep telling myself that, and I know it's going to be. So I also know that Santa Claus is coming, so I want to sing a Christmas song, and I think I want to do Santa Claus is Coming to Town, because we know he is.
And there's lots of kids out there that are watching the show too.
Oh, yes, and you know, even my own grandchildren. They're down in Purnsboro. Hi, guys. If you're there, I believe they are, unless they found something else to do this afternoon. Santa Claus is coming to town really soon. So sing along with me. Sing a few more in between, Mary Janet.
I think that's a wonderful idea. You take it away.
All right, I'll just take it away. All right, I'm gonna do a song that I truly love to sing. I'm sure Mary Janet is very familiar with this song. It's called Belfast Mill.
I
learned this song. I've heard it sang by many people, and I always loved it. So I kind of grew to it in the last year or so, and I've been giving it a hook. So. I'll sing this one for you, Mary Janet.
Thank you.
Oh, and you can sing along too. Mary Janet has the most beautiful voice, you all know. She has talent both in her voice and her feet. I do not have talent in my feet, so so she's got one up on me for sure.
That was long ago.
Oh, so nice. It's all there, Mary Janet. Thank you. thank you, Mary Janet.
Lynn, I don't know if you knew this, but last year we went to Ireland.
Yes, I did know that.
Went to Ireland on a tour, and Cecil and I went, and we were, there was about, 28 or 30 of us there. And I kind of help out with the tour. It was Ron McCacken.
Yes,
and, he has...
our dream list.
Yes.
Like, okay, sure, we're going to go.
Sandy Travel. And, I mean, it's been a hard year because all of the tours got canceled because he does Ireland and Scotland. I've done two or three of his Scotland tours with him and Ireland. And he does Italy, Portugal. Anyway... there's still a chance next year we're going to do the Switzerland trip,
yes.
Whatever. But Ireland, oh my God, we loved that Ireland trip. It was absolutely incredible, and all through Belfast,
yes.
And the bars and the songs,
yeah.
And the history behind the songs and the sorrow in many cases. And we
absolutely.
Went up to Derry, and all of the songs that you hear now, they make sense because
right.
We were there at those
absolutely.
Spots. Just absolutely
that is
incredible.
My dream. I'm trying to learn as many as I can so I can sing at a bar.
You absolutely.
My dream.
And they get you to come up. I went up and I sang at
nice.
One of the bars. I did.
I feel jealous.
A mother's love is a blessing.
Oh, how
it's,
nice.
It's, because it's an Irish boy
right.
was leaving.
Yes.
And I said, what
yes.
the heck? And we all had so much
how
fun.
How nice is that? Well, there
yeah.
you go.
Okay.
I just, it's on the bucket list.
On the bucket list?
Yes.
It can happen. We're not saying that we're not going in September because there's a chance that the trip may still happen.
Right.
Depending on vaccines and
right.
all of that
we
stuff.
We need to be hopeful to make it happen.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be our 50th wedding anniversary next year. And this was on our bucket list to go.
Well, it's going to happen, isn't it,
so,
guys?
Maybe.
There we go.
Maybe.
COVID.
All right.
Yeah.
Get away from us.
Absolutely.
All
oh,
right.
that's, yeah, very nice. No, all the songs, I dream of going to Ireland. There's such a connection with us, right?
Well,
yeah, absolutely. Okay, well, maybe I'll go back to doing another Christmas song. And this is one of our Rita McNeil's songs called The Season Will Never Grow Old. And so I've kind of grown on this song many years ago, and I've done it quite a few times. So I'm going to try giving it a little hook here this afternoon.
Spirit be with you wherever you go.
vintage.
A true Cape Bretoner.
You can just feel everything in this song. Yeah, you know, you can imagine the kids sleeping and the snow on the trees, the first ones to go, you know, that kind of stuff.
100%.
So beautiful soul.
Yeah, a beautiful soul.
Mm-hmm.
We still have a few minutes for them to be tempered completely.
Okay.
They're getting there. There's another 8 minutes.
Okay.
And we'll just have to wait. That's it.
Absolutely. Well, I'll just have to keep singing then, Mary Janet.
Yes,
that's why I'm here, isn't it, folks? Yes, exactly. She knew what she was doing, didn't she? Well, you know what? I'm digging through my pile. I usually have all my songs in a little binder. So I'll go to a gig. I never know what I'm going to sing. Sometimes that changes up because people will look for different songs. And so I just found a Ricky Skaggs tune, so I think I might do it. It's called Crying My Heart Out Over You. So it seems a little sad, but I do like the melody of this song. So we'll give it a little bit of a hook. We don't have the mandolin today, but that's neither here nor there. So off somewhere.
So I'm just going to tell you now what we're going to be doing next week. So next week, we're going to be going over to Mitchell's house. Haven't done a show from his. And Cecil's going to be there. He's going to have the guitar, too. And Mitchell and Gordy. And some of the grandkids will be there. And who knows? You just never know who will drop in, but we'll try to keep it
COVID friendly
within family. And we're not going to introduce a new recipe next week. We're actually going to be going back to the very first show that started it all. And yay, Cecil. we're going to make cinnamon rolls. All of our kids that are out west and the ones in Halifax, some of them might not even know this yet, we're going to have them on a computer on Zoom, and we're making cinnamon rolls together as a family, and anybody out there who wants to join in on that, and we're going to have lots of Christmas songs next Sunday. So anyway, I hope that be okay. No new recipes. Let's just do this and celebrate. It'll be great.
Wow.
So I've got just a couple more minutes left before I can pop out those beauties, and I'm going to beg to Lynn to sing another song, and then I'll bring you over to the table. Actually, what I'm doing right now, I melted some white chocolate. I'm going to put a little drizzle of white chocolate on some of them so that you can, it'll just be a little differentiation. Is that how you say that?
Well, it looks beautiful from here, whatever she means. It's beautiful looking.
Okay, here we go.
All right.
We'll get Lynn to entertain you for a song or two, and I'll be ready soon.
Well, isn't that going to be something else next Sunday, folks? Having that family all doing music together and Zooming, and they are certainly a fun family. And share it well. So I'm going to do something then called I Can See Clearly Now. I can see clearly what Mary Janet is doing right now with those beautiful truffles. I love it. The tea is moving in on the it's served in the beautiful china too.
It's just beautiful. You can have a sip of your tea there, and I'll bring you some chocolates in a moment, but I'm going to take you over here, folks. Sure. Thank you, Lynn, again. That was wonderful. We'll get one more song as a closing song very soon, but I am going to say a prayer that these little darlings are going to be nice and pop out of the mold like they're supposed to. These are two from last week. Okay, let's give it a go. If you have a hard plastic one, they should pop out okay. And if you're having trouble with any of yours, it just means that maybe it's not tempered enough yet and we have to put it back in the fridge. So I'm just going to say a prayer that they'll come out. And I don't think they're going to. I might have to put them back.
They're just being stubborn.
They are being very stubborn, but they will come out. This one is almost ready. I can see that. You don't want to do it too badly. You don't want to mess it up. My hands are all full of chocolate. Look at that. Hold on till I wash my hands.
400 of those at one time here, Janet.
Oh my God, I did it.
I did it. Yeah. Anybody else having any good luck with theirs? You know what? I think I have to put it back in the fridge. Oh, there's the first one.
Yeah, so the rest of them are good too.
Well,
they'll come out. I can't stand anything on my hands because it would make a mess. And when you take them out, you have to be so careful that you don't. It's a good idea to actually use some rubber gloves.
Okay, so there is the first one. Can you see it? It's a nice and shiny heart. All right, because if you touch it with your fingers, it will take your fingerprint. So I'm just gonna, I have a little tray here. Can you see my tray? And I'm going to put that in there. And I'm going to pray that I can get the rest of these out without too much trouble. If I had the nice hard plastic, which I suppose like with everything else, Amazon, you can get the hard plastic one. See, there's another one. And just so I can show you what I'm, for something to be different. Can you see that? Okay. See, I have three here that I want to show you. And I have melted some white chocolate in this. I got this little thing from Tammy from Pamper Chef, and I just love it. So I'm just basically going to just make a little drizzle over it. No matter what you put on, it's going to look just fine, right? And I'm going to get my little tiny spatula and put one in there. That'll harden up. You really should put it back in the fridge, but just so you know what you'd like to aim for, of course. Yeah, Mary Janet. Yeah. Can you see that? So cute.
Oh, it's beautiful. So artsy. The chocolate.
Look at this. I'm just upsetting everything here. Now I'm going to try my best to get a couple more out of there. Really, it probably means that they haven't been in the fridge long enough. But usually 20 minutes will do it. But I just wanted to show you if I had the darn hard ones. Let this go. This one is ready to go. Come out. I can see it. You can see it's starting to separate. Okay. Okay, there's one. So, what I wanted to show you are the little foil sheets that you get. They're just little foil sheets of this, gold on one side. You put one in there, and you wrap it up. And it's just like a little chocolate. And you just put it in a little cup like that. I mean, that's a poor excuse of one. it's just, if I could just, I'll take one of these. And what I should have done, if you can see that, put it upside down and then fold it over. That's right. You wrap it up like that and put it in your little paper. They're so cute. Oh, and like I showed you in that one little movie, And then, the dollar store had these cute little things that you can buy for a dollar and load them in that. So, Lynn, I'm going to put this up. I'm going to.
Oh, those
did I give you
so
a napkin?
Beautiful. Oh my gosh. And my dad.
I'll go over here.
Oh my goodness. I'm really spoiled.
So you take your pick. Maybe try one of the ones that are.
I will.
You already had one of those.
Exactly. So I'll try this. Oh, it looks beautiful. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
So
here's a few
so
of them.
So dainty.
But if, for example.
Oh, Mary Janet.
Aren't they decadent?
So good.
I know. And.
Well.
I'm going to have one too.
Very, very nice.
I'll take a little bite.
Wow, you're so smart to do, so creative.
The best white chocolate for melting is the melting wafers, and you buy them at the bulk store. Somebody just said that. I didn't catch the name. Mm. Oh my gosh. They
so
are so good.
Good.
I'm just, not because I made them. It's just the recipe.
Oh my goodness. There's been lots of tests going on this evening.
Oh no. But like that, if you can't get them out, put them back in your freezer.
Mm, that's very, very nice.
I'm going to have a little cup of tea here with Lynn.
Wow. Cheers, Mary Janet. Very nice.
Cilantro.
Cilantro.
So we're going to bug Lynn for one last song. And then we'll finish it off while she's finishing up the song. And we'll see you next week at Mitchell's the same time. And if you're into it, let's make cinnamon rolls. thank you, Alice Waters. Thank you very much. Another great afternoon.
Yeah. I think I'd like Mary Janet to sing along with me. How about out there? What do you agree? And I think we'll do a little bit. We'll do a couple of ending pieces. We'll bring one into the other.
Sure.
Feliz Navidad.
Oh,
we'll try that
yes.
one. And then we'll end and we wish you Merry Christmas. So I think that'd be kind of nice to do and
beautiful.
Be able to sing with Mary Janet.
All right.
I'll just move myself a little more this way so that I don't hit you with my guitar. There, we'll turn this way. Okay, so where am I going? I'm just going to the A for this one. Okay. Ready? Okay, let me see. Together and thank you folks. Thank you again for Mary Janet for having me here. This was so much fun.
Thanks to Lynn. Isn't she just had the most beautiful voice? And look for her online, where online music sales. I'm not even sure all the spots, but
yeah, you can just Google me. Google me.
Google. It's become a new term.
Right, exactly. Okay, so
we wish you a
Merry Christmas.
Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Now bring us a big pudding. Now bring us a biggie pudding.
We're still, we're allowed to hug.
Yes, exactly. She lives behind, I live right behind her on E Street.
That's right. Okay, folks. Oh, that was so nice. I just so many favorite things. So make sure that, show me some pictures of what you've made and if they turned out okay and they came out of the dish for you. Well, my aunt's grand, I missed that message, but anyway. I know everybody's feeling the loss of being together, but we have to find innovative ways of celebrating and not feel, you know, don't get down about it. It's just the way it is this year, and we're going to get through this together. And just know that you really matter to me, as you know you matter to me. And I love you, and I want you to love everyone. And we'll see you next Sunday at 2:00. I love you all. Bye-bye.